Good morning, class 8th. Today we will discuss about harmful microorganisms. Microorganisms can also be harmful to us. Some of the microorganisms causes disease in human beings, plants and animals. Such disease causing microorganisms are called pathogens, and they can spoil food, clothing and leathers. Okay. So, disease-causing microorganisms in human beings we will study first. Pathogens or harmful microorganisms can enter in our body through the air we breathe, water we drink, food we eat, and they can also be transmitted by the direct contact. For example, this hand is having some microorganisms and this is healthy. And if it will come in direct contact with this, then the harmful microorganisms can be transmitted from this hand to this hand also. Direct contact, this was the medium of transmission of harmful microorganisms, okay? And they can also be carried out by a person or an animal also. And these disease, those can be spread by food or physical contact, water, air are called communicable disease. Okay, examples of such disease are cholera, common cold, chickenpox and tuberculosis. Okay, when a person suffering from common cold sneezes, fine droplets of moisture carrying thousands of viruses spread in the air. Okay, and these viruses may enter in the body of a healthy person while breathing, and it can also cause infection to a healthy person also. Okay, so whatever be the situation, you can use mask also. And these days we are suffering, all the world is suffering from the coronavirus. So whenever you will move out, first try to keep yourself in your houses. Whenever you will move out, then you can use mask over there. Okay, that mask will definitely protect you from the harmful microorganisms or pathogens. And there are some insects and animals which can also act as the carrier of disease causing microbes. Okay, house fly is one of the carrier, and the flies sit on the garbage and animals excreta. Pathogens stick to their bodies when these flies sit on uncovered food, and they may transfer the pathogens. Okay, and so it is advisable always to keep your food covered, as well as avoid consuming uncovered food items. If you will use these kind of food items, then they will definitely going to affect your health. And other thing is, another example of the carrier is female Anopheles mosquito, okay, which carries the parasite of malaria. Female Anopheles will act as the carrier of dengue virus also, and it can also be cause of malaria. So because of malaria, all the mosquitoes will breed in the water. Hence, one should not let water collect anywhere in the cooler, tires, flower pot, as well as keeping our surrounding neat and clean or dry, we can prevent the mosquitoes from breeding. This will help us to protect us from malaria or other life causing disease. And now I will discuss some disease that are caused in human beings by the microorganisms. For examples, tuberculosis, measles, chickenpox, polio, cholera, typhoid, hepatitis A, malaria. There are some disease and they can be life causing also. And what can be the cause for these disease? For example, tuberculosis, it can be spread by the bacteria. mode of transmission can be air. How you can prevent yourself? Keep the patient in complete isolation. Keep the personal belongings of the patient away from those of others. Vaccination to be given at a suitable age can also be another preventive measures. Okay, other disease also there, rest of the disease as well as their cause, mode of transmissions and preventive measures, I will send you in another screenshot. So today what we discussed some disease, those can be caused by the harmful microorganisms, and later on we will discuss also about the disease, those are caused by microorganisms in animals as well as in plants also. Okay, thank you so much. Till then, enjoy your day. Have a good day. Thank you.